You are listening now to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
Says like this,
Dai, pois,
give
César
to Caesar,
o que é de César
what belongs to Caesar,
e a Deus o que é de Deus.
And give to God what belongs
Deus
to God. Those
quem
who
anda com Deus,
walk with God
quem
and are of God
no Senhor Jesus,
and who believes in the Lord Jesus,
dá a César,
they give to Caesar,
o que é de César
what is Caesar's,
isto é,
meaning
os impostos,
the taxes,
ainda que sejam
although
injustos,
it can be
ainda que sejam
unjust
injustos,
or just,
ainda que esses impostos não
even if
beneficiar
the tax
o povo,
may not benefit
mas
people,
ainda assim,
but although
nós
we
temos a obrigação
have the obligation
de dar a
to
César
give
o que é de
Caesar what is Caesar's.
É lei.
It's a law.
César exige
Caesar
a lei,
requires law,
então,
the fulfillment of a law.
Temos
que so we must fulfill it. We must obey
a César,
it.
O que é de
so
César.
Give to Caesar what is Caesar's.
A Deus, o que é de Deus.
And to God what
então,
is God's.
É fiel nos dízimos,
so those who are faithful
ser infiel
in the tithe,
no que é de César.
They cannot be unfaithful to Caesar.
Realidade.
That's the reality.
Você é fiel nos dízimos,
you are faithful in your tithe.
Nas
you are faithful in your offering.
Mas se você é infiel,
but then you are
César,
unfaithful
dizer,
to Caesar. Or you're unfaithful to tax
então
or whatever,
you roubando,
are robbing.
Roubando,
you are robbing
usufruindo
and you are taking advantage of what is the devil's.
Assim. Não é que os
it's not saying, I'm not saying
diabo.
That the tax is
mas
of the devil, no.
Rouba,
but when you are, when you fraud,
o roubo é uma
when you commit theft, is
então
a weapon of the
rouba,
devil. So when a person steals,
Deus,
whether they steal
César,
it from Caesar or from God,
essa pessoa
they,
está manipulando
they are manipulating
uma ferramenta de
a
Satanás.
Tool that is of the devil.
E obviamente,
and obviously,
obviamente, essa
obviously
pessoa
this person
vai colher os frutos
will reap the results
não adianta você
of this
honrar
action.
A Deus com os dízimos
so
e ofertas,
you can't just honor God with your tithes and offering and then you rob Caesar's.
Você tem que pagar os impostos.
You have to pay
eu pago
the tax.
Os meus impostos.
I pay my
eu
tax.
Sou obrigado a pagar
I
os
am
impostos.
Obligated to pay
mas ainda
my tax.
Que não fosse obrigado,
but even if I was not obligated,
eu teria que pagar os meus
I would
impostos.
Still have to pay.
Porque
because
é a ordem do Senhor
it is
Jesus.
The
o
order
Senhor
of the Lord Jesus.
Diz pra mim, assim,
my Lord tells
César
me, you give
é César,
Caesar what is Caesar's.
E a mim, o que é meu.
And me, what is mine.
Então, se eu obedeço
so, if I obey
de Deus,
God's word,
Jesus,
if I believe in
fato,
Jesus,
na prática,
in the practice,
então, eu
so then,
pago a César, o que é de
I give Caesar what is Caesar's.
E não tenho
and
a minha consciência
I will not have my conscience
por conta de roubar
guilty
alguém.
Because I'm
eu
robbing someone.
Ninguém.
I will rob no one.
A única pessoa que eu
the
posso
only person
é
that I can
Satanás,
rob is
alma,
the devil. I can
é
rob
inferno.
The souls from
aí
the devil.
Temos que fazer isso.
And
nós
we must do that.
Alma, é
we
want
to remove that soul that belongs to God and remove
mas
it from the devil's hands.
Os impostos,
but the taxes,
quem é de Deus, quem é justo, quem anda
those who are righteous, those who walk
honra
in justice,
César,
they honor Caesar,
com que é de César
with what
Deus.
Is Caesar's. And they honor God with what
essa
is God's.
É a lei, essa é a
this
palavra
is
de Deus.
The
assim,
law. This is the word of God.
Vivo na lei,
oh, but I don't
sim,
live
claro,
in the law.
Quem disse
but
isso foi Jesus.
Jesus said it.
Não foi no, na lei, não.
It
tá
was not in the law. It's written here.
A César,
give
que é de
to
César,
Caesar what
Deus,
is Caesar's.
É
and to God what is
se
God's.
Você for fiel a
and
Deus,
if you are
não,
faithful to God.
Não pagar
but you do not pay your taxes. With integrity, you are robbing.
Governo,
you are robbing the government.
O roubo
And robbing is a tool from the devil. You are utilizing, you are using of this weapon to take personal benefit. And I ask you, will you have any benefits from it? How many people are faithful in the tithes and offerings, but they are not righteous in paying their taxes or paying their bills? So then, things will get worse, because the devil will proclaim and say, Lord, he or she give you the tithe, give you the offerings to you, but he is robbing, he or she is robbing in regards to the tax or people. So they are using my tool, they are using my strategy. So the life, a person's life will be tied up because they are unfaithful to Caesar. They are unfaithful to the tax or to someone. Ah, bishop, but the government, the politicians, they use my money in a way, in a wrong way, or take possession, they steal. It's the problem of the government. I have to do my part. And if they rob your money, that's their problem, not yours. I need to do my part. I have to play my part. And what they're going to do with my with the money I give, I don't know. The same is with the tithes and the offerings. I honor God with tithes and offerings. And if by any chance the pastor is robbing, is manipulating the money in a wrong way, it's going to be his problem, not mine. I, as a servant of God, a servant of God, I live my faith, so then I do what Jesus told us to do. Whether people like it or not, I will do what Jesus said. And this is His word. So you, my dear listener, that you are listening to me right now, you need to know that our faith is distinctive, different from the faith of this world. We are not of the world. The world is not in us, and we don't live according to the laws of this world. We live by the word of God, and we need to obey and give to Caesar what is Caesar's, and to God what is God's.
The service is nearing an end. The choir is singing just as I am. And now as the old song is played, people at the altar are kneeling down to pray. And some are finding mercy, forgiveness for their sins. Some are fighting battles and they're struggling to win. The time has come to give them to the Lord. That's what this altar is for. That's what this altar is for. You don't have to carry those burdens anymore. There's a light in the darkness, and there's a love that's true. And Jesus is waiting, He is waiting here for you. Go quickly now before they close the door. That's what this altar is for. A father is praying with his son. A mother kneels beside them, thanking God they've come. An old man is standing there in a part of Him that He's held back for years. Hearts are being broken, lives are being changed. Those who call upon Him, they will never be the same. The time has come to give in to the Lord. That's what this altar is for. That's what this altar is for. You don't have to carry those burdens anymore. There's a light in the darkness. There's a love that's true. Jesus is waiting, He is waiting here for you. Go quickly now, before they close the door. That's what this altar is for. That's what this altar is for. You don't have carry those burdens anymore. There's a light in the darkness. There's a love that's true. And Jesus is waiting. He is waiting here for you. Go quickly now before they close the door. Your burdens to the Lord. That's what this altar is for.
Faith and intelligence go together. Although faith sounds crazy to this world, it's intelligent because it makes us know that we can be happy. Faith also keeps us from accepting a life of defeat and allows us to fight to conquer a life of victory and success. If nothing is going according to plan, it's time for you to use your intelligence and faith to bring to existence the desires of your heart. The Universal Church, a place of faith to change your life.
I used the term rob the souls from hell or the devil, but that's not the right term that I should have used. It's to take back. It's to recover the souls that belongs to God, because the souls are of God. The devil takes possession of them. So we have to recover them. We have to recover the souls that are of God. Back to God's kingdom, not to rob, because the devil doesn't own the soul. We naturally, when we bring God's word, we recover the lost soul that were in the hands of the devil and back to God. So we are going to listen to testimonies of people that had their lives changed, and they put their lives on the altar. Let us listen then to the testimonies of these people, and they had their lives transformed.
My name is Diana. Before I came to the church, my life was miserable. I was hooked on drugs for 10 years. I have 3 children. I exposed them to a miserable life, along with their father. It was both of us. We had no money, no food. Every penny, every dime we got was to add up to more drugs. My children had no food, no luxuries. We were just miserable. I felt pain. I felt stress, not only for me, but for my children as well. I would see them hurting. I would see them wanting, and I couldn't provide. And to know that they went to the refrigerator and had no food was painful to me, knowing that I would have the means to give them food, but instead of providing them with basic needs, I would instead provide for our drug habit, and it hurt. We used to have to go get food whichever way possible, and it was an everyday struggle, all day, every day. My children's father, we were together for 16 years, and he was the one that introduced me to crack cocaine, cigarettes, a few years after we met. So it was a 10-year process, 10 years of addiction. There came a time we didn't even have food in the house, and we had to go out and get food in every way possible, whether it was stealing it, going to pantries, you know, because all the money that I used to get was for the addiction. I found out about the Universal Church through my son's best friend's mother. We used to go pick up our children at the schoolyard every day, and that was my son's best friend. And she, you know, I got to speak to her about, oh, you know, times are rough, never in details. And she told me to come on a Friday, the day of deliverance. And I went, and I liked it. The first time I went was late March, and I started going every day. I became a faithful tither, and I did my chain of prayers, but I strayed. And my life was great while I was in the church. When I left in May, everything fell apart again. Everything fell apart. My life again was miserable, full of depression, full of stress. My children were miserable. I came back in June, and since June, I've been committed and determined to change my life for the better with the help of the church. And I've been seeking God and the Holy Spirit. And everything from then has been a ray of sunshine in my house. Diana today is a changed person. No more addiction, not even cigarettes. Just the thought of smoking a cigarette gets me sick. My children are happy. They stopped being rebellious. We have prosperity, we have joy, and we have peace in our household now.
So this growing up, I had a lot of problems in my family with my dad and my mom. My dad would cheat on my mom, and it would be something that it wasn't just one time, it was several times with different women. I hated him for what he was doing to my mother. I hated him because he was hurting her, and at the same time I was angry at her because she wasn't doing anything about it. She was letting it happen. She would get upset, but then later she would forgive him and she was just taken back. So that would make me angry, but I never had the boldness to confront her, to confront him. She would lash out, I guess, with her problems and everything. She would get angry at me. She would say things that really hurt me. She would say she, you know, hated me. She would say, you know, why did I have you? It was such a mistake. I remember as soon as I was old enough to understand, to know what is wrong and to make a wrong decision, she would just start on me. Everything that I would do was not good enough, and she would just yell at me for it and get angry and say, you know, you're worthless. Why did I have you? I'm going to put you up for adoption. Nobody wanted me, especially her, because of feeling that inferiority. I was depressed. I would think maybe, you know, since nobody wants me, since everything is so horrible, my life is pointless, then maybe it's better if I did die. Well, when I was going through all this pain, I was feeling lost, depressed, just pointless, worthless. I never blamed God. I didn't feel I was worthy enough. I had always been taught that God was good and I was bad. And God was always right and I was always gonna be wrong. You don't have to be like this. This is not who you are. And when I started to see that, then that's when I really started to change. Going was what made me strong. To fight against the problems, to react good, to really make a change in my life, I wouldn't have had the strength to do that. I would have just kept living the life of pain and accepting it. Now everything is really good. Me and my mom have a really good relationship. I love her very much and she loves me. And we get along perfectly, you know? And I see my future really bright. I see possibilities, I see great things because I chose the right path. if God helped me, if He saved me from these negative thoughts, from this feeling of inferiority, of worthlessness, then I know He can help you. I know no matter what you're going through, no matter what situation, no matter how negative, how horrible you feel, He can help you, and He has the solution.
This lonely pilgrim land, raising strong and mighty fortresses, I alone command. But these castles I've constructed by the strength of my own hand are just temporary kingdoms on foundations made of sand. In the middle of the battle, I believe I never know the thrill of victory till I'm willing to lay down all my weapons of defense and earthly strategies of war. So I'm laying down my arms and running helplessly to yours. I surrender all my silent hopes and dreams. The treasure I obtain, if I measure my successes on a scale of earthly gain, if the focus of my vision is the status I attain, my accomplishments are worthless.